Hey, what's up? This is Amarjit Singh from Motion Mago. Today we are gonna be creating this cool looking 3D text animation. The process is pretty simple and without using any third party plugins. You are really going to enjoy this. At the end, as usual, we will have endless design possibilities. That's why I request you to watch this 3D text animation tutorial till the end. So, without any further ado, let's jump right into the After Effects and get started. Create any composition. Let's name it text. I am going with HDTV 1080 preset with a default frame rate and duration 10 seconds. Select the text tool and type your text. First of all, we will create a 3D text animation like a twister. So let's say we will type twister warning issued, right? I'm using a very beautiful font, Monument Extended Ultra Bold. Align the text to the center of the screen by clicking the Align Horizontal and Align Vertical. By the way, if you don't see the Align panel here, simply go to the Windows and click the Align. Okay, now go to the composition setting and make the comp size just fitting for the text. It's 1180 by 90. Now we will create a new composition with the opposite dimensions. Like we will take the width 90 and height 1180. Oops, forget to name the composition. Let's name it colored strip. Now drag the text comp into it. Rotate it at 90 degree. Now create a new solid layer. Choose any color you like and hit OK. Move this layer behind the text layer. Create another composition and name it white strip. We will keep the dimensions same as the other strip. Hit OK. Repeat the same steps. Drag the text comp into it. Rotate it 90 degree. Now create a solid and change its color to white. Put this white layer behind the text layer. As the text is white too, let's change the color of the text. Go to the Effects and Preset panel. Find and apply the fill effect. Change the color in the effect control panel to black. Now open the colored strip comp, select the text layer and go to effects and preset panel, find the effect motion tile and apply it to the text layer. At the beginning of the animation, create a keyframe for tile center in the effects panel, go to the end of the timeline and animate the text layer upwards by changing the tile center. Open the white strip comp and apply the motion tile effect to the text layer. Animate the tile center as we did in the previous comp, but downwards this time. Create a new comp, name it designer element. I will go with HDTV 1080 and duration again 10 seconds. Drag the colored strip into it. Find and apply an effect called CC cylinder. It looks weird. To fix it, just click the little star icon, which is Collapse Transformation Tool. Press the R key to open the rotation property and rotate it when it looks like this. I think it's good at minus 86 degree. In the effect control panel, let's change the render to outside. It will eliminate the backside. Now drag the white strip comp and apply the CC cylinder effect to it and fix it like we did earlier. Rotate it until it matches the colored strip layer. I think minus 76 degree is fine. Change the render to inside this time. Hey, can you spare a couple of seconds for me? If you really like what I am doing, please consider giving it a thumbs up and leaving a comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe as well. Okay, let's move on. Open the rotation under the CC cylinder and change the rotation Y. Let's say to 165 to match the other layer. Now change the position Y to make it look like this. I think minus 130 works well. Preview the animation now. As we see, the white strip is rolling in the wrong direction. To fix it, press the S key on the keyboard to open the scale property of this layer. Then click the unlink the X and Y properties and change the Y property to -100. Now preview the animation. It looks perfect now. Let's create a new comp. Name it Animation 1. Click and drag the designer element into it. Now press Ctrl D to create multiple copies of it and make the design something like this. Create a null object, attach all the layers to it, adjust the scale as required. Select all the layers and pre-compose by going to the layer menu, then pre-compose. Find and apply the mesh warp effect and reduce the rows and columns to 1. Select the corners of the mesh and by pressing the arrow keys to left or to right, design it as you like. Let's make a twister shape. Now play the animation. Wow, it looks great. To make it more interesting, let's add a grid to the text comp. To do that, we will open the text comp and create a new layer and apply the grid effect to it. Adjust it as you like. Looks much better now. To make it glowing, just create an adjustment layer and apply the effect glow and bring the opacity down as much as you like. We can add some background as well. Let's preview the animation now. It looks great. If you find this tutorial helpful, please consider giving it a thumbs up and leaving a comment below, and don't forget to subscribe as well. Let's move on to the second animation. Create a new composition. Name it Animation 2. Drag the designer comp into it. Let's add some background. To do that, create a new solid layer and apply the effect Gradient Ramp. Make the gradient ramp radial and adjust the colors as required. Go to the designer element comp and hide the white strip layer. Open the colored strip comp and for the text layer, increase the motion tile output height to really high, like 2500 or above. Open the animation 2 comp and you will see a new design is ready. Now we can design the comp as we like. To fix the cutout, open the design element comp and increase the comp height to really high. It will solve the problem. Now we can design it as we like. The best part is, if we change the strip color or change our text to something else, it will automatically update in our design. Now we have endless possibilities. We can make multiple copies of the layers and design them as we like. So that's wrap up today's tutorial. Hope you guys like it. One request to all of my valuable viewers, if you find any steps difficult in this tutorial, please let me know in the comments below. I will personally resolve your query. If you really like what I am doing, consider liking, sharing and subscribing to my channel. We'll be right back soon with another useful tutorial for you guys. Till then, take care.